Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. This episode of Students with Jashandeep is brought to you by Filippo, Loreti, and we have got Shivaan as our guest on our channel, and he's currently pursuing medicine in King's College London, and that's the experience which we want to explore, that what was the application procedure to study MBBS in the UK, and secondly, what is the cost of studying MBBS, and thirdly, the scholarships, and some fun conversation around general UK student life. So let me straight away put Shivaan on the spotlight, and I would request him to introduce himself. Please, Shivaan.
As you said, hi, I'm Shivaan. I'm a first year medical student at King's College London. And I'm also an international student, and I've come from New Delhi in India.
Well, thanks for that, Shivaan. It's great. So could you let us know that when did you develop your interest in doing MBBS? And secondly, from picking from that point onwards, that what was the application procedure looking like in order to come to UK and study medicine? So please.
Yeah, right. So basically, as far as I can remember, medicine is what I wanted to study, because in ninth grade, when I really started considering what I want to do as a profession or what I want to do in my higher education, I thought that I liked science a lot, and I wanted to do something around that. But I also wanted to go into a sort of dynamic profession that involved more than just sitting in a lab or sitting in an office. And so I decided that I wanted to do medicine, and it's what I've wanted to do ever since. And now the application procedure, it starts in 11th grade, mainly around that time, but 10th grade is also important, because whatever results you get in your 10th grade exams, they do play a important role in whether you get into medical school or not. But after that, you need to be focusing on things like work experience in a medical setting, which is like internships, shadowing, observerships, and then also volunteering, which involves working in care homes, any sort of caring environment, charitable organizations, things like that. And then in 12th grade, obviously, you'll be studying whatever course you're studying, whether it's IB, A-levels, if you're in India, if it's CBSE, ISE. But alongside that, you'll also have to give entrance exams, such as the UKCAT or the BMAT, depending on which university you want to apply to. And then you'll be writing your personal statement, which is true for anyone who's applying to university in the UK. And you'll be submitting your entire UCAS application by October 15th. And after that, you get interview calls from university. And you have to give your interviews, and here your interview performance is the sole sort of factor that determines whether you get into that medical school or not. And then you get an offer based on your interview performance. And if you meet that offer in your final exams, you get into that particular medical school.
Yeah, got it. Thanks for that. And is the biology necessary in order to pursue medicine as your career?
So in the UK, you have to take chemistry. That's the only required subject. But but along with chemistry, you have to take another science or math subject. And I would recommend you do take biology. It's the most helpful one. Most of what you study here at university in medical school is related to biology, so that will definitely be the most beneficial subject to take.
For sure, thanks for answering that. And also, just out of curiosity, what's the difference between UKCAT examination versus BMAT examination?
So the UKCAT is a reasoning based exam. It involves like reasoning skills related to math, abstract reasoning, verbal reasoning, and there's a section on decision making. It's basically a lot of logic and analytical thinking, versus the BMAT is more knowledge based. It's related to knowledge of GCSE science and math, which is 10th grade science and math. And there's also an essay component to it. And the BMAT is used by only a small amount of universities: Oxbridge, Imperial, UCL, Brighton and Sussex, okay. Lancaster, versus the UKCAT is used by all the other universities. So that's the difference between the two of them.
So now is the time to thank the sponsors for our today's episode of Stories with Jashan, which is Filippo Loreti. Filippo Loreti is a premium watch brand and it is inspired from the Italian architecture. So even I just got my watch delivered just today and it's really comfortable to wear. You can use the discount code Jashandeep15 and you can avail your 50% discount offer. You can use this code unlimited for 3 months time period. So what are you guys waiting for? Do check out Filippo Loreti and get the premium experience for the watch brands. And the other thing which I really love about them is that these are very affordable watches. Now usually for the other brands, their cost is very high due to the fact that there's a middleman involved. With Filippo Loreti, they are shipped directly from the brand itself, so there isn't a middleman commission involved. So that's why they are really, really affordable, and that's something which I really like about this brand. So do check out Filippo Loreti and avail the discount code Jashandeep15. And what will be the good starting point in order to prepare for such examinations? So here, can you please clarify what is the cutoff marks, for example, in order to get into the UK university if you're giving UKCAT? Then secondly, how to prepare for this examination? Was anything which you will recommend which has helped you in your journey?
Yeah, so the UKCAT is basically the cutoff for the UKCAT. I mean, there's no particular cutoff for most universities, and they definitely don't release a cutoff till after you've applied. But I'd say if you're applying as an international student, a good score is something that's 2800 and above out of 3600. But that doesn't mean you cannot get in with a score that's lower than that. But if you have a score that's higher than that, you're definitely in a very good position. And preparation wise, I'd say the thing that helped me prepare the most is just sparse preparation, like spreading my preparation out through a long period of time. So I was preparing for like 3-4 months before, doing some amount of preparation every day. It's the test is to do with acquired skills, so if you practice it little by little over a long period of time, you'll get very good at it, versus just cramming hours and hours into the 1 week or 2 weeks before the exam. So that's what I'd recommend for preparing for the UKCAT. And there are a lot of resources. There's Medify, there's the official UKCAT website. There are a lot of resources available online.
Agree. Was there any book which you specifically recommend for the students, for the aspirants?
Yeah, so there's this book called The 1250 Questions on the UKCAT by ISC Medical. So that was the only book I used, and it was very helpful.
Great, thanks for sharing this, Shivaan. This will be really helpful for the people who are planning to apply for medicine in the UK. Then moving on, what I assume is that the cost of living will be quite high in order to do medicine in the UK. So could you please break down that, what is cost of study for medicine field in the UK?
So the cost of studying for medicine in the UK, it's in universities outside London, it's usually around £33,000, but in London it's around it can vary from £38,000 to £41,000 a year. And on top of that, if you're applying to Oxbridge, preclinical years are around £35,000, but clinical years can be up to £60,000, and preclinical years are basically for first and second year.
Thanks for that. So out of curiosity, why is the cost of study in the London universities higher compared to rest of the UK? Is there any specific reason? Or is it like the London universities have got good ranking? I don't know. What's the reason for that?
I'm not exactly sure why it is, but I'm assuming it's because the cost of training doctors and the cost of resources and all in London would be higher.
Okay, I've got that point. I understand that, you know. Yeah, better. So, like, I understand, like, this is a big amount of sum of money which you have to invest for your studies. So, was there any scholarships available for you to apply?
There are no scholarships that I've heard of, because scholarships are very rare for international students, and especially if you're an undergraduate international student studying medicine, it's very rare to find a scholarship, and there are none that I've heard of. This might change, so I would say stay on the lookout for something. But yeah, mostly because the sum of money is so high that you would need a very large scholarship to make any significant dent in that fees you have to pay.
Yeah, so I think the students they have to prepare, that they have to pay by their own. So if your parents are your sponsor, it's like mainly the funding has to be coming from you rather than expecting the scholarships to help you out. Because even I did my own research, for example, even I'm doing undergraduate course in chemistry with drug discovery, and one of these scholarship was the Commonwealth scholarship, which is kind of fully funded scholarship if someone want to apply, but that is not applicable for the undergraduate students. So that's only applicable for the master students or higher than that if someone wants to do PhD. So for sure that the scholarships really doesn't help much in your funding, especially when you're doing an undergraduate degree, the same as Shivaan is doing. So is there something which aspirants, the future aspirants who want to pursue medicine, what should they be keeping in their mind before actually doing medicine? Because I'm sure you have got some experience right now. So on basis of that, what are things they should be keeping in their mind before doing MBBS?
So one thing you want to keep in mind is don't study medicine just because you like studying science and biology, because there's a lot more to medicine than that. There's a major human aspect. You have to want to be dealing with people on an everyday basis, and you need to develop your people skills, and you need to be good at interacting with people, because that's a large part of what this is. And I would say it seems like a lot of work studying medicine. Everyone says, oh my god, it's going to be like medical school, it'll be crazy or anything like that, but it's not. You can balance it out well, and you actually have a really good time at medical school, both studying medicine and with the rest of your life as well. So yeah, I'll just say that.
So my last question would be like, what does the cost of living really looks like in the London area? Is it like, I assume it will be quite high. So what's your accommodation price, your transportation cost, what's the food cost? What's your like total kind of the monthly budget which you have to spend in the London area?
So my accommodation is around £8,000 a year. And so I'd say living costs can vary, but they're between £300 to £600 a month here. And yeah, you definitely end up spending money on your main expense would probably be food, and after that so you'd spend money on transportation as well. But yeah,
great. Okay, thanks for letting us know this as well. Then now let us talk a bit about having a career of a doctor. Now let's say you've completed 5 years of your MBBS, then what's the next step? Is it like you have to do some kind of specializations in order to become a doctor? So what is the full length process to become an ultimate doctor, you might say, in that typical terms?
Yeah, so once you finish your 5 years or 6 years at medical school, then you go on to your foundation years as a junior doctor, and you have to complete 2 foundation years. After that, you choose what you want to specialize in, but you also have to do 2 core training years after that, which is CT1 and CT2. And then you have to do a few years of specialization, and depending on what you want to specialize in, that time can vary from a couple of years to like 5 to 6 years. Yeah.
Okay, now I've really got that. So you've done 5 years of MBBS. Now once you're working for 2 years as a junior doctor, so my question will be that, is it like you have to yourself look for a job in NHS, UK NHS, or is university going to help you in order to get that training to become a junior doctor, just to be getting trained during that period?
So if you get through medical school, you will get a placement, but it's depending on your performance in medical school and other things like that, that decides where you get your placement.
Okay, let's say now let's say like someone has got like a job as a junior doctor and he's training himself. Do they get paid for doing that placement, and what is the salary levels if they get paid?
So junior doctors do get paid, yeah. And I think I'm not 100% sure again about what the exact number is, but I think it's around between £25,000 to £30,000 a year.
Yeah, that's fair.
For a junior doctor, yeah.
Great. And okay, so then you move on to your core training again for 2 years, like CT1. CT, I mean, is clinical training, right?
Core training, yeah.
Core training, okay. CT is, yeah. Core training. Core training 1, core training 2. And again, you will be getting paid in those years as well. Mm. And then you move on to doing your specialization for another 2 to 3 years. Then finally, you become like specialist in one particular field. Might be it's like a GP or it's like cardiologist or whatever different fields you've got, then you become an ultimate doctor.
Yeah, exactly.
No, I think it. I think like MBBS or becoming a doctor is a field where, I mean, like finances is always like a mental stress in your brain. But I think if someone wants to do medicine, like what I think is that you have to become like more compassionate, that you have to serve the humanity or you have to serve the patients rather than coming in this field thinking about earning loads of money. Because I can clearly see that, because I can clearly see that from this conversation, when you're in your initial years, you can't really expect to earn loads of money. You have to really invest during that particular period.
Yeah, the money is not the reason you want to become a doctor. If that is the reason you want to become a doctor, you'll be disappointed by the amount of work you have to do to earn that much money. You should do it because you want it, you enjoy doing it, and you're interested in it, and you want to, like you said, you want to help people. That those are valid reasons for doing medicine, and not money, for sure.
Really great. Thank you for this. Okay, so my wind-up question would be that what does your future plans really looks like? Are you planning to settle in the UK?
I'm not 100% sure of what I'll be doing right now, but for now, I do want to work in the East, at least start working in the UK, and I'll take it from there.
Yeah, good. And any last piece of advice for the students who are watching this video, who are planning to come to UK or aspiring to come to UK?
Definitely I'd encourage everyone who wants to apply to the UK and who wants to come to study in the UK to come here, because it's a great place to study. It's a great country. There are so many great cities around here. If you come to London, you'll have a great time. I'd say if you're applying to the UK, definitely don't stress yourself too much throughout the application process. Just make a plan in which you basically outline everything you have to do and when you have to do it, so you're never behind on anything and you'll be able to do all your work and all the necessary steps to a good standard. And that's it.
Thank you Shivaan. I really want to appreciate Shivaan as well, because the way he has laid down from the application process to cost of doing a medicine, from scholarships, I mean, it has been really, really clear. Because when I was in my high school, I had a lot of interest towards biology and I was thinking that I should be going for MBBS, but there wasn't that much resources available to watch online that how does the application process look like, and especially, for example, doing 5 years of MBBS, 2 years of a junior doctor, 2 years of core training, then doing specialization. I didn't have no clue during that time. But if I had watched this video during that time in which I would share this information, it would have been really, really helpful for me. And I assume for the audience who are the aspirants, they would be finding some value out of the from this video for sure. By the way, for the audience, Shivaan himself has got his own YouTube channel. He makes all the content related to UK student life, especially related to the medicine field. So if you've got any questions, make sure you're pinging him on the Instagram, connect with him on the Instagram, and also go to his YouTube channel. He's already made a bunch of videos and start watching them as well if you're planning to do medicine in the UK. And thanks Shivaan for taking your time, and also for the audience. Thank you and have a nice day ahead. Cheers.